Hey everyone. Over the past few videos, we have been talking about the electron configurations of ground state atoms and ions. Throughout those videos, I stated that there are a few minor exceptions to the general rules. So I just want to take some time now and address those exceptions. As we learned in the previous video, electron configurations must follow Aufbau's principle. Aufbau's principle states that we must place our electrons in the lowest energy states first, and then work our way up to higher energy states. As a way of remembering the various electron energies more easily, we can create this matrix here, and easily remember the direction of higher energy orbitals. If you need a quick reminder on Aufbau or any other electron configuration rules, check out the link in the description below first. So, there are two primary exceptions to Aufbau's rule that will relate to us. Our first exception states that when we have an electron configuration ending in d9, I should preface this by saying it is not all d9 orbitals. It is only for copper, silver, and gold. The reasoning this trend doesn't continue beyond gold in column 11 of our periodic table is a bit more complicated. However, if you're curious, you can take a quick look on Google for an explanation. So, as an example, let's use copper. Copper has 29 electrons, which we would suspect has an electron configuration of 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 3d9. However, our exception states that when we have a d9 orbital, our atoms would rather take an electron from the next lowest s orbital and fully stabilize its d orbital. The reason that the atoms prefer this electron configuration is because the d orbitals take up a lot of energy to maintain. By moving the orbital to a d10, our atom's electron cloud becomes a lot more stable. Therefore, anytime you see an electron configuration ending in d9 for copper, gold, or silver, just remember that we don't like d9 orbitals, and we want that to become a d10. So, to conclude, our first major exception of Aufbau's principle is that d orbitals that are one electron away from being fully saturated will take up an electron from the next lowest energy s orbital, to ensure that the large, higher energy d orbitals are fully saturated. The second rule is actually very similar. However, it is for half-filled d orbitals. So, anytime we see a d orbital for chromium or molybdenum, we actually do the same thing we did in our d9 exception. We will pull an electron from our next lowest s orbital to stabilize better the higher energy d orbital. So, for an example here, let's look at chromium, which has 24 electrons. According to Aufbau principle, we would suspect an electron configuration of 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 3d4. However, as we were saying, this d orbital will pull one of the electrons from the s orbital into the d orbital to half saturate it. This is a lot more stable for the electron configuration. And in both these scenarios for chromium and molybdenum, this is a more stable electron configuration. I will leave a link in the description down below that shows you the electron configurations for all atoms on the periodic table. And then you can use that as a reference when completing examples for solving the electron configurations of given atoms. In addition, I will post a second link down below that talks about all the elements in which there are electron configuration exceptions, so check that out as well. Just remember that the main reason we have exceptions to the way we assign electron configurations to atoms and ions is due to the atom finding a way to make itself more stable and best hold on to its electrons. However, the main ones you should recognize are chromium, molybdenum, copper, silver, and gold, as these are common examples that teachers use on tests to trick students. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of what the electron configuration exceptions are. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking the join button down below or our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.